All right, everyone. Welcome to another edition of Unstoppable REI, and I am here with the amazing Claude Diamond. There's only the one and only. So thanks, man, for gracing me with your presence and for taking the time to do this. I know you're a busy guy, so I'm gonna just jump right in, man. So just tell me your story. Tell me, I know you've got a lot of stuff that you're doing. You've been in the business a long time, so. Give me your 30-second or 30-hour elevator pitch.
30-hour. Oh, basically, I've been I'm a private real estate investor, been one all my life. I've been mentoring people in 24 different countries for about 32 years now. Started out in like most people, you know, everybody said get a good job, get education. I did that, went into corporate America, didn't like it,
right?
You know, you know when someone's giving you a paycheck, you got to do what they tell you to do.
Absolutely.
And that doesn't work well for my personality. Decided, well, let's go to law school. I went to law school. Left New York City, New Jersey, with my wife, moved to San Diego, went to law school. Always had a fascination for the law. I still do. I have a doctorate in law, and wow. I discovered that lawyers are not the happiest people in the world, and they don't have a lot of, they have to work a lot of hard hours.
Okay.
And, I think part of success is doing something you love. And being richly rewarded for it. It has to be practical. We all want that good life, right?
Sure.
So, you know, and I was very fortunate. Before I left for California, I got into real estate. I had that, remember when you got real estate fever?
Totally, absolutely.
Yeah, went to all the gurus, all the seminars, bought all the books and the tapes and things like that. Worked like hell. And then I had to get a second job besides my corporate job to support my tenants' way of life because they sure weren't paying me on time. You think it's bad today? It was, you know, so I was a bad, I was doing real estate wrong.
Yeah.
I was learning it the wrong way. And I was very fortunate. I met this really sweet old guy and his name is Max. I've written several books about him in business books. And the man did something I've never seen. All the seminars, all the education, he did something I've never seen anyone do before. You don't want to hear about this, do you?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Oh, okay. I'm teasing you.
I know.
I saw him, right? I heard about him by reputation, and he was doing real estate, lease purchasing, a lot of different things. But he was a remarkable salesperson, and I saw him close a deal in one phone call.
Wow.
Okay. And he made more money in that one phone call than I made in a whole year in corporate America with all my real estate. I had a few properties running around everything, and he made more money in one phone call. And I said, how did you do that, man? And he says, I don't know. I just did it. And he was what you call a natural charismatic salesperson.
Gotcha.
He had that special gift. He couldn't even explain it. So what I did is I was interned for him. I was kind of his gopher, you know, all this education and all this stuff and everything. And I'm fetching him coffee and bagels.
Sure.
Because I got the $1 million education and I knew it. It was one of those moments in life when you know you're around a real person. It's like being, if you could shadow Warren Buffett or Steve Jobs or somebody like that and just cut through all the superfluous poop, you know, just get right to the kernel, right to what do they do? And he was, and what I learned from him is he was the world's greatest salesman.
Okay.
And I was the world's worst salesman. A man, I couldn't give away $20 bills on the street corner. I was shy. I was reluctant. I read scripts. Scripts are caca in my world.
Sure.
I might get a little, can I use adult language here today?
Yeah, totally. Absolutely. It's for adults only. Yes.
I didn't know what kind of audience you have. So that was the beginning of me. In the next 6 months, I left my job. I went to California. I started making money. I got out of debt, which I always wanted. I was in very high consumer debt.
Okay.
The rest, it's been a great ride for the last 32 years. We've always had enough money. All I had to do was give good phone, talk to people, do my real estate deals. And then I started getting into the mentoring part of the business. I'm sorry, that was much longer than 30 seconds.
Oh, I love it. I love it. So you hit a couple of things I wanted to come back to. So first of all, You are an investor, but your strength really is in your salesmanship. Would you say that? So you could sell whatever. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. You know, and if it's one message I want to get to you, to all your listeners, this is the one takeaway.
Okay.
If you can just learn a sales system, understand the psychology, the empathy, how other people think and feel, and use the right words, the right enunciation.
Yeah, yeah.
To people, you are free the rest of your life. Mike, if sales is the $1 million skill, we go to all the seminars and stuff, and I'm not knocking my competition,
but
they give so much busy work. Oh, you got to get this application, you got to hire this acquisition manager, you got to get VAs, you've got to do text marketing and all that. The only thing you have to do to go to the bank and have a wonderful life,
yeah,
to know how to get to persuade another person that you're an honest and trustworthy person and you give great value.
Bottom line.
Take that away, ladies and gentlemen. You've got to be superb in sales. You can't get away with it. You cannot text yourself to be a millionaire. I'm sorry. This is my opinion. Anybody can disagree. This is what works for me and I'm nobody special.
Yeah.
But I love talking to people and solving their problems. And I don't read a script. I ask questions.
Yeah.
I get information. I offer solutions. I close people.
Yeah.
My word of honor. I close people all the time in one phone call because they like and trust and see the value hopefully I'm giving.
Totally, totally. I was going to mention that I've seen you do it live many, many, many times. So I know exactly what you're saying. So what's interesting about what you're saying, though, is that I mean, and you're right, no matter how many VAs you have, no matter how many, you can know 1,001 different ways to buy real estate, no money, no credit. But if you don't know how to close the deals, and like you said, understand, well, I'm going to say in your terms, give good phone.
Good.
Yeah, you're
lost
done.
That. Rufus, haven't we lost that skill? I think we're so busy texting and emailing and all the macro work, we forgot we have lost the God-given skill of just talking to one other person.
Yeah,
and
I agree.
There's one thing I do this with my students. I mentor, I have great students. I love to teach my students all my stupid stuff so they stay away from it and all the stuff that made me, I run a multi-million dollar business and I love it. I'm debt-free. I live in Colorado, California, North Carolina. I'm not trying to brag like an idiot.
No, I understand.
It's all about knowing how to talk to people.
Yeah.
We're like doctors out there. That's the way we got to look at it. People have problems and can we go to them? If you were, God forbid, were sick and you went to a doctor who was caring, empathetic, said, Rufus, we're going to make you good as new. I am going to take such good care of you. We're going to give you the right prescription, the right physical therapy. And don't you love that person?
Absolutely.
Love.
Absolutely.
That's what I try to do with people in real estate and in sales training and mentoring.
That's phenomenal. So tell me, what is good phone? I mean, you're throwing so much stuff at. I'm trying to keep track because I want to come back to it. No. I love it. Keep going.
I love this stuff.
Yeah.
I love talking to people about, I hold nothing back, by the way.
Yes.
You know, I just want people, my mission in life, I have everything I need. My mission in life is, because I don't want people to go through what I went through, spending a lot of money and getting a lot of just one little piece of the puzzle. It's not that you don't need the motivational speech and the computer applications and the telemarketers and all that stuff. It's not that you don't need that stuff.
Yeah.
It's just not. There's one thing that will get you to the bank today is if you know how to communicate sincerely the right way with a person.
Yeah.
One-on-one in the phone. You know, I'm running a business. I have no employees.
Wow.
I have nobody. I don't have acquisition managers and VAs. I don't have any of that.
Yeah, yeah. I love
low overhead, high profit, secret of success, 101.
So let's talk about good phone, man. Tell me about that. Tell me, how do we do that? I mean, you said it's not a presentation. It's not scripts. It's asking questions. So talk me through that. Give me some examples, would you?
Giving good phone. Great question, by the way.
Yeah.
You and I, this is the first time we met. My pleasure.
Yes. Yeah, mine too.
Are you and I having any trouble having this conversation? We just hit the ground running.
Absolutely.
We met a few minutes ago and everything. We're relaxed. We're confident. We have no mandate or anything like that.
Right.
giving good phone means you have to have the science and the art. The science is the psychology of human behavior. I've spent years and years researching many different psychologists and psychologists. And what does it take to get another human being to pay attention to you, to respect you, to listen to you, to want to like and trust you, to do business with you? Right. What is the science? There is a science behind that.
Right, sure.
You know, what most people do that's wrong is they read a script. Hi there, Mr. Thibodeau. My name is Claude and I'm with ABC Investment Corporations and I'd like to have a minute of your time. What do you think goes through their head, Rufus?
Oh, you're wasting my time. Who is this clown on the phone?
And you get 100% rejection. So you don't understand. The word is empathy.
Okay.
You don't understand how they think and feel. You're not the first person to call them. Right. And you're saying the same old tired bullshit. They've heard 100 times before.
Absolutely.
Then there is the giving good phone also involves the art form.
Okay.
Different people, different personalities, different wants and needs. You have to tailor the conversation to stay in control, but make that you have some people who are A personalities, B, C personalities. Some are introverts, some are extroverts. You have to spontaneously make a decision how you're going to speak to this person. What is it they really want?
Right.
So it's an art form too. I call it being a thespian. My wife and I helped build the theater here in Colorado, the Grand Lake Repertory Theater.
Okay.
We were founding members of the building there. My daughter's an actress and she does voiceovers. She just did the Panda Express commercial.
Oh, is that right?
She does voiceovers. You got to have a little bit of acting skill, not to be manipulative or disingenuous, but to just make people comfortable with you.
Sure. No, that makes total sense. Total sense. It's all about people understanding people. So let me, go ahead.
That's good phone. And we put it together in the gut sales method. So you have three little steps that anybody can memorize. You don't need a script. You have these three little steps and you learn how to ask questions and dialogue with people. And my God, the magic just happens.
Okay. Can you tell me what those three steps are? Is that longer than we have time for?
Sure. Agenda, three little steps like a staircase.
Okay.
We have the agenda, the qualification, and the close or commitment to close. The agenda is where you set up the rules of the conversation with the person. You take an authoritative leadership role. If I was gonna role play with you, Rufus, I'd say, Mr. Thibodeau, can I call you Rufus? I'm Claude. Is that all right, sir?
Oh yeah, sure, that's fine. Yep.
I wanna help you. I know you have a problem buying, selling, and investing in real estate. I'd like to just ask you two or three quick questions so I can learn more about you. And then I'm gonna offer you several solutions. I will even make you an offer on your property if that's the way you'd like to go. And if not, would you do me a personal favor and just fire me if we can't move forward today? Would you do that for me, sir?
Sure. Please? Absolutely. Fair enough.
That's off the role play. That's an agenda. I just set the rules. I got your permission to ask questions.
Okay.
I'm going to find out about your pain, your need, your greed, your problem. And I told you I'm going to make you an offer. Did I do that in the first 15 seconds?
Yes.
Yes.
Nice.
15 seconds. I have set up the whole premise for making offers and closing or getting out. That's a system.
Number two.
We need to qualify people. I don't know what their needs are, their motivation. I don't know what their financial status is at the time. I don't know what their time frame is. I don't know if they have the authority to make a decision or they have to go to a spouse or a board of directors.
Right.
And do they have, I like dealing with honest, decent people. Do they have the character? If we decide to make a commitment today, I'm big on commitment and accountability.
Okay.
Do they have the character to keep that commitment? That's step number two.
Okay.
And we do this by learning, and this is where this is the heart of the guts sales method. It's learning how to ask questions.
Okay.
But questions by their very nature are abrasive.
Okay.
Somebody cross-examines you. What time? How much? And then you have to do it in a certain nuance.
Okay.
You have to learn how to ask questions with what we call stroking and nurturing. A stroke is a sincere compliment. A nurturing is to make it heartfelt and emotional.
Okay.
These are things I learn with my students. We practice every week. Okay. Role playing is, I don't know anybody else who does that, but I do this exclusively with my students, one-on-one in groups. We role play and we practice real calls or just practice and we record. Sure. And if I can get them to that wonderful big C word, confidence.
Yeah.
So without, yeah. without reluctance, they can get to the phone and give good phone and do this consistency. We all hate the phone a little bit, don't we?
Yeah.
I mean, with the, if you're using tradition, here's the death of success for majority of people out there. Can I tell the truth or should I
sugar? No, tell the truth,
A failure rate, I think you even sent that to me in your introductory email. Why, you said, Claude, why is the failure rate so high? Remember that?
Yeah, absolutely.
You said something in there. The failure rate is astronomically high and nobody wants to talk about it except your Uncle Claude here. Okay. It's very high. Because all the programs and instructions and college courses and everything don't teach people how to sell, how to persuade, how to influence. It is the million-dollar skill. Once I learned it, I was free forever.
Wow.
I mean, I was, and when I say free, I mean making money with a phone.
Yeah.
That's all I needed. I just had to do some good marketing. If we have time, ask me about marketing.
Yeah.
I get free, warm, quality leads every day.
Let's talk about it right now. Tell me about marketing. Let's go.
Okay, sure. So we got the first problem. People are reluctant to go on the phone because of the high rejection rate.
Yes, okay.
I get this from so many students. They say, Claude, if I do another phone call, I'm going to go crazy.
Right.
I'm reading the same script. They're asking the same questions. And then they tell me I'll think about it or call them later or hang up on me. How long can you do that, Rufus, before you just procrastinate?
Not very long at all.
You can't. Okay, so we have a sales system. That's good.
Yeah.
And to make the sales system really work well, Guts has its own dedicated, unique, patented, copyrighted marketing system.
Okay.
Okay. And basically, life is much easier if you have warm calls. And we have the technology today.
Yeah.
I get free warm calls, leads every day. And I spend, guess how much money I spend?
I'm going to say zero probably, right? I knew it. How did I know that? Okay.
Zero.
Wow.
Okay. Most people, you're in this business.
Yes.
How much do most people, I'm thousands,
tens of thousands
every month.
That's right.
On leads.
Yeah.
And I'm going to use one bad word again. And most of those leads are shit.
That's right.
They're garbage leads. They're taken from lists that were scraped. And then you put them into a system or hire someone to call these people. They don't know who you are. They didn't want you to interrupt their day or their meatloaf dinner.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you're just calling people based on an algorithm because they had a late pay or foreclosure or an absentee owner. These really obscure, overbroad macro algorithms that they use.
Totally.
So I don't want to waste thousands of dollars and call people who don't want to be bothered. None of us want to be bothered.
Right.
So why do the same kind of marketing that we hate when we get interrupted during our day with texts and email spam and phone calls from robots and stuff like that? Isn't that insane to do the same thing that we personally hate?
Yeah, but we do it anyway, but you're right. It is insanity.
But we do it anyway, and it's not, and it's even illegal in certain states and in instances too. So what I decided is let me attract.
I love it.
How do I attract them? I give away a ton of shit for free.
Wow.
I do videos. I do interviews like this. By the way, all your here's my new book, the Gut Sales Method Rules.
Yes.
It's all these different rules on giving good fun. This is free to all your. I never sell stuff. When I do an interview, I give stuff away for free.
Okay, so we'll get that information, how to contact in just a minute, but we'll keep going.
Your audience has to just Google Claude Diamond or ClaudeDiamond.com. Go on my webpage and they can have it for free as my gift to your audience today.
I love it. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
What did I just do?
Just now?
Yes, now. What did I just do with that little bitty commercial there? I'm giving it away for free. I'm not selling any. It's a nice book, by the way. I sell a lot of them online too, but for your audience, they get it for free. What am I doing right now?
You're marketing?
Yes.
No, what? Is that what you're doing?
What am I doing? I'm giving away.
Oh, you're attracting. You're pulling them in.
I'm doing this interview. People are going to say, that guy is crazy. He's not, I don't want it. Or maybe that guy has some value. I like what he said. I like his energy. And he's giving me away a free book. Am I bringing people in?
That's right. You're not chasing away. You're not running after them. You're drawing them in. Yeah, I love it.
So John and Mary, listen to your wonderful podcast.
Yeah.
They get my free book. They go to my webpage and schedule a free consultation for 15 to 30 minutes with me. And they say, Claude, I think you offer value.
Yeah.
Maybe they'll bring me a deal. Maybe they want to buy a deal. Maybe they'll want to take my one-on-one mentoring program. I'm bringing, isn't this common sense?
It is common sense. You know what, Claude, it is common sense, but it's so simple that people miss it because just like you mentioned, people are scared to have conversations because they're anticipating, they're scripted, they gotta, you know, because that's not even real world. That's not even real conversation. But they can instantly have a conversation with the guy at the, you know, bus stop or the gas station or whoever, just a conversation. And if you're giving something, hey, you know what? I know somebody has that. Hey, I've got one of those at home. I'll send it to you. I mean, you're adding value, you're offering value, you're drawing people in instead of just sounding like everybody else on the planet chasing after them and they're running away. And it makes so much sense that it's hard almost because it makes so much sense. You know what I mean? It's so easy. People miss it.
Yeah. I have thousands of videos on YouTube.
Yeah.
This gets even better, by the way. Of YouTube, I'll put a video in, I'll pick a topic. I do this every week.
Okay.
2 to 4 minutes. How to find a property, how to close somebody, what's a lease purchase. I give away better free material than what other people sell because I have no other inclination other than to attract people and let them, you know, nobody knows me. Nobody woke up this morning, unfortunately, and said, hey, let me call up Rufus Thibodeau or Claude Diamond and give them a shit full of money. It's that full of money. Okay. They don't do that. I have to earn that trust.
That's right.
And I do that by giving no fluff. You ever go to a webpage and it's the pop-ups and you scroll and scroll and scroll. And all they want to do is capture your email.
That's right.
Okay. But they're not giving you any VE. And then they spam you to death. I don't spam people.
Yeah. Yeah.
I only cut. Okay. And the thing about it is I put all these videos in YouTube. From YouTube, I can share them on my Facebook, on my Twitter, on my LinkedIn page. One video.
Yeah.
Click, click, click. And now it's all over the universe. Okay. Now it gets even better.
Okay.
Guess what YouTube does once you get over 2,500 subscribers?
They start sharing it for you, don't they? Oh, they're paying you.
They start paying me. You're a smart young man. They start paying me.
Wow.
I get thousands of dollars. I get a check every month, thousands of dollars a year from Google, from YouTube, owns YouTube, the number one webpage in the world.
Yeah.
They send me a check. So not only do I get paid for these warm leads, I get daily warm leads coming in. These people buy my products. They bring me deals. They retain me for consultation or mentoring. Am I telling too much truth today?
Maybe I should hold back. No, don't hold back. I love it because it's so simple that anybody can do it, but people don't because they're busy. They're out busy, you know, knocking on doors and putting out bandit signs and chasing after people who don't want to talk to them. Where if they were attracting people, they position themselves much higher, more valuable to the person, and they could actually have a conversation with somebody that can turn into a deal. And like you said, you turn it into a video that you can monetize and create money from, get paid to attract people to you. How much better could it be than that?
And all I do is these videos. I do public speaking. I do interviews like this.
Yeah.
I do live streaming, a free webinar. I give away tons of stuff for free, quality content. Contemporary content that's of value to other people. And they say, gee, you know, what do we do when we find somebody or something that we're interested in? We Google it, we research more, we go to the webpage, we look for videos. I love videos. And that's how I bring people in. Rather than chase people who don't want to be bothered,
that's right.
I attract people in. And then I talk to them and I use guts to sell guts. I'll go right to the system. Sir, why are we talking today? What would you like to see happen? Can I learn more about you and your needs and problems? Can I ask you 2-3 questions?
Yeah.
And then I move to the qualification because if they don't have any money or they want to buy $1 million, they don't have any money. Maybe there's nothing there for me today.
Yeah.
And then we go to my famous 3-minute timer. All my students get this because we qualify people in 180 seconds.
Wow. So, all right. So you're giving me, and I knew this was going to happen. You're giving me way more than I anticipated. So here's what I want to be able to do. Is it possible for us to maybe talk another time or two? Because I would love to maybe do some role playing. I would love to, because you're giving.
Why not right now?
Huh? Well, you know what, here's what I have to do. We'll probably have to do, I've got to shut this down and do another one because I've only got 30 minutes on this one. So how about that? I'll shut this one off and call you right back and we'll go again, okay?
Okay, sounds good. See you folks in a little while.
Okay, sounds good. Bye now.
Bye-bye.